This is Klaus and Kate's house. Kate has heard that too much radiation from radioactive material may be harmful. But luckily, there is no radiating material around. Or is there? You see, Klaus has heard of a radioactive material called radon. So he goes and buys a measuring instrument that can detect radon. He measures upstairs where Kate lives, downstairs, and in the cellar. And he wonders. In the cellar, he can detect lots of radon, on the ground floor some, and even upstairs where Kate is, he can still detect a little. He asks himself, where on earth does this material come from? And why is there more of it downstairs than upstairs at Kate's? Under the house, there are layers of soil and rock. There you can also find a natural radioactive element called uranium. Over time, the uranium decays and forms new materials, among them a gas called radon. Radon is radioactive too, and is thought to be the prime cause of lung cancer apart from smoking. Since radon is a gas, it can rise. Along joints or small cracks in the walls of the cellar, it can enter into the cellar and accumulate there. Klaus and Kate don't want to breathe in the gas and try to get as far away from it as possible. But didn't Klaus detect some radon upstairs as well? You see, the gas can spread through the entire house and disperse into every nook and cranny. Klaus and Kate become a little bit anxious. Just how can they get rid of this dangerous gas in their house? The easiest way is to give the different rooms in the house a good airing so that the gas cannot accumulate but will escape. But although they may give the house a good airing, there is still too much radon in the cellar. An expert advises them on how they can achieve better isolation of their cellar to stop the radon coming in the first place. Klaus and Kate are already feeling better, so airing the rooms regularly is the thing to do. After all, a bit of fresh air isn't a bad thing.